In the previous lecture, we have studied about optical isomerism. Today we'll study more about enantiomers. See, enantiomers are the pair of organic molecules which are having relationship of non-superimposable mirror images. One of the example shown above, it is an achiral molecule and it is forming a superimposable mirror image. How we say that it is achiral molecule? See, the carbon is bearing two similar methyl groups. It is not having all the four groups different on it. So it is achiral molecule having two similar methyl groups on it, and it will form superimposable mirror image. Whereas in the lower example, it will form non-superimposable mirror image as the four different atoms or groups are there on the central carbon. One is Br, one is methyl, one is ethyl, and one is H. And this is a chiral molecule, it forms non-superimposable mirror image. When we superimpose this compound on this one, it is not superimposable because this H is pointing on the front, on the right side, whereas this, in this isomer, it is pointing on the left side. A chiral molecule is the object. It has a non-superimposable mirror image. As our hands, they are non-superimposable. When we try to keep the right hand on the left hand, it is not completely superimposing. The two thumbs, they are pointing on the opposite sides. An achiral molecule or the object has a superimposable mirror image. Isomerism of organic molecules and chirality. See, what is the key difference between a chiral and achiral molecule? In chiral molecule, we see here all the four different atoms or groups are there on the central carbon, whereas in achiral molecule, all the four groups are not different. It is bearing two methyl groups which are similar, whereas in chiral molecule, one is Br, one is H, one is methyl, and another is ethyl group. This carbon is called asymmetric carbon. The central carbon is asymmetric carbon, and this carbon has all different groups on it. Chiral molecule will form non-superimposable mirror image, whereas achiral will not form non-superimposable mirror image. Optically active molecule or chiral molecule should have one asymmetric center or a chiral center. That is a center which should have four different atoms or groups on it. It should form non-superimposable mirror image. Sometimes what happens, there is no asymmetric center, still the compound is optically active. Then what is that? See, the molecule is asymmetric. That means it should not possess any element of symmetry like plane of symmetry, center of symmetry, rotation, reflection, axis of symmetry. There should be no element of symmetry in the molecule. Then we say the molecule is asymmetric and it will form non-superimposable mirror image. In this way, the important condition for optical activity is asymmetric molecule and it should rotate the plane of polarized light in opposite direction. Then isomerism of organic molecules, we'll study about enantiomers. As chiral or optically active molecule with only one chiral center will have two isomers. One rotate the plane of polarized light to right and other will rotate to left. Here we are showing an example which is forming non-superimposable mirror image. See, this is 2-bromobutane. The carbon is bearing four different atoms or groups, and this is the mirror image of this molecule. And we see that this molecule is not superimposable on its mirror image. Therefore, such pair of molecules or isomers are called enantiomers, as they are the relationship between as the relationship between them is of non-superimposable mirror image. how we name the individual isomer. See, in IUPAC system, Kahn, Ingold and Prelog devised RS system of nomenclature to indicate the configuration of the atoms or groups about the asymmetric center. Pair of enantiomers with one asymmetric carbon, one will have R configuration and the other will have S configuration. The RS nomenclature, as given by the rules of Kahn, Ingold and Prelog. See, first of all, what happens in an asymmetric molecule, we decide priority to the atoms or groups attached to the asymmetric center. Here, there is hydrogen atom, a methyl group, bromine and Cl. The atomic numbers are hydrogen is having 1, carbon 6, chlorine 17 and bromine 35. Out of all the four, the bromine is having highest atomic number, so it is given priority 1. After that, the highest atomic number is of chlorine, it is given priority 2. Then carbon priority 3, methyl group is given priority 3 and hydrogen is given the priority 4. In this way, we rank the groups or atoms bonded to the asymmetric carbon in order of priority. The atomic numbers of the directly attached to the asymmetric carbon determine the relative priorities. The higher the atomic number, higher is the priority. As we have seen, the bromine is having highest atomic number, is given priority 1, then chlorine, then carbon, and then hydrogen. If the two substituents bonded to the asymmetric carbon start with the same atom. See, in the example, the carbon is bearing methyl group and a ethyl group, both are starting with carbon. How we decide the priority? Then we move further and we see to which atoms the carbon is attached. In case of methyl, the carbon is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms, whereas in case of ethyl, the carbon is attached to 2 hydrogen and 1 carbon. Out of these 2, ethyl will get higher priority as compared to methyl. In this way, the atomic numbers of H is 1, carbon 6 and chlorine 17. Out of all the 4 groups, chlorine is given priority 1. And out of methyl and ethyl, see, ethyl is given priority 2, as the carbon is bearing 2 hydrogen and 1 carbon. Whereas in case of methyl, the carbon which is attached to asymmetric center is bearing all the 3 hydrogen atoms, so it is having lesser priority as compared to ethyl. Therefore, methyl is given priority 3 and hydrogen is given priority 4. In this way, we move outward from the point of attachment and consider the atomic numbers of the atoms that are attached to the tied carbon, that is the asymmetric carbon. If an atom is doubly bonded to another atom, the priority system treats it as if it were singly bonded to 2 of those atoms. If an atom is triply bonded to another atom, the priority system treats it as if it were singly bonded to 3 of those atoms. As we see in case of C triple bond N, the carbon is attached on 3 sides to the nitrogen atom. Whereas in case of C triple bond CH, the carbon is attached on 3 sides to the carbon atom. In CHO group, carbon is attached 2 times to the oxygen atom. If the two atoms have substituents of the same priority, higher priority is assigned to the atom with more of these substituents. Out of CHCl2 and CH2Cl, see, the CHCl2 is having two Cl atoms and one hydrogen, whereas in case of CH2Cl there is one Cl atom and two hydrogen atoms. So the substituents more in number gets higher priority. CHCl2 has higher priority than CH2Cl. A larger group that is more atoms may not necessarily have a higher priority over another that is smaller group. In this case, CH2Cl has higher priority than the butyl group, as the CH2 carbon which is attached to the asymmetric carbon is bearing two hydrogen and one Cl, whereas in case of butyl, it is bearing the carbon which is attached to the asymmetric carbon is bearing two hydrogen and a carbon chain. Therefore, as Cl is of higher priority as compared to carbon, so CH2Cl gets higher priority as compared to butyl group. In the case of isotopes, atoms with the same atomic number but different mass number, the mass number is used to determine the relative priorities. In this example, CHD has higher priority than CH2, as the mass of deuterium is 2 and the hydrogen is 1. So in case of CHD, it gets higher priority than CH2. In the example shown here, the carbon is bearing 4 different atoms or groups on it. The highest priority is given to bromine, and second priority to ethyl group, and third to methyl, as the carbon of ethyl is having 2 hydrogen and 1 carbon attached to it, whereas carbon of methyl is having all the 3 hydrogen atoms. And the least priority is given to hydrogen, priority 4 is given to it. And on the right side, there is mirror image of the same compound. As we see on the left, there is hydrogen on the right side, whereas on the compound which is on the right side is having hydrogen on the left. They are making non-superimposable mirror images. So this is an enantiomeric pair. These are called enantiomers. The isomers which are having a relationship of non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. Then how to find out R and S nomenclature once when we decide priority? See, draw a curved arrow from 1 to 3 back to 1 and note on which direction this arrow goes. If from 1 to 3 we are going clockwise, it is R configuration, and if we go anti-clockwise, it is S configuration. See the example where from bromine 1, ethyl 2, methyl 3 on the left one, we are going in the anti-clockwise direction, so it is having S configuration. Whereas in this one, from bromine second one ethyl and third is methyl, we are going in the clockwise direction, it is R configuration. One important thing has to be seen here, that the lowest priority atom or group should be kept behind the viewer, that is on the dotted line, as it is visible here. The hydrogen atom is kept on the dotted line, kept away from the viewer. If the lowest priority group is behind the plane of the molecule, see the H is behind the plane of the molecule shown on the dotted line, whereas the methyl group is shown on the bold bond. It is projecting in the front side of the plane of the paper or plane of the molecule. And the bonds which are normal, they are in the same plane as they are shown in. If the lowest priority group is in front of the plane of molecule, then the assignment is reversed. That is, clockwise is S and anti-clockwise is R. This is an assignment. Assign R and S nomenclature to these molecules. Then we'll go for specific rotation. Optically active compound will rotate the plane of polarization. See, this is the normal source of light having vibration of particles in all the directions perpendicular to the propagation of light. When such light is passing through polarizer, we get a polarized light having vibration of particles only in one direction perpendicular to the propagation of light. This is the sample tube. If it is containing a chiral compound, the plane of polarized light is rotated. See, this was the plane initially here shown as here, and this has been rotated in the clockwise direction in this way. This is in the clockwise direction, it has been rotated here. So there is some angle of rotation. The observed rotation alpha is measured in degrees. The observed rotation depends on the concentration of the sample, what concentration we are taking of the sample in this tube, and the length of the sample tube. Also the length of the sample tube, the alpha is depending on both the factors, concentration of the compound taken here and the length of the sample tube. The observed rotation also depends on the temperature, the wavelength of the light source and solvent. For a given temperature T and given wavelength lambda, observed rotation alpha is related with specific rotation alpha lambda T as alpha lambda T. That means this is the specific rotation at a particular wavelength and at a particular temperature is equal to alpha upon L into C. Alpha is the observed rotation, L is the length in decimeter of the sample tube, and C is the concentration in gram per ml of the molecule. In this example, see, this is S2-methyl-1-butanol. The alpha with D line and 20 degree centigrade, it is -5.75 degree, whereas the enantiomer of this compound, that is R2-methyl-1-butanol, the specific rotation is +5.75 degree. As you see here, the magnitude is same, 5.75 5.75, only the direction is different. One is rotating in anti-clockwise direction is represented by minus, and the other, which is rotating in clockwise direction, is represented by plus. The specific rotation is the number of degrees of rotation caused by a solution of 1 gram of the compound per ml of solution in a sample tube 1 decimeter long at a specified temperature and wavelength. That means this specific rotation alpha at a particular lambda and T becomes equal to the alpha when this L is taken as unit decimeter, 1 decimeter, and this concentration is taken as unit concentration, that is 1 gram per ml. Then this alpha becomes equal to the specific rotation at a particular lambda and T. Specific rotation is specific to a molecule. That means every molecule will have a particular specific rotation. We can characterize a molecule by its specific rotation. R and S, they give you the configuration. What is configuration? Configuration is the orientation of various atoms or groups around the asymmetric center. And it is not necessary that if the configuration is R, it will have plus rotation. There is no relation between the sign of rotation and configuration. It should be very clear that the configurations are given by the orientation of various atoms or groups around the asymmetric center, which can be assigned by Kahn-Ingold-Prelog sequence rule by looking to the molecule. Whereas we cannot give the sign of rotation to the molecule by just looking theoretically. They are measured in polarimeter. After measuring, we can find out whether it is dextrorotary. If it rotates the plane of polarized light in clockwise direction, it is dextrorotary and given plus sign. Or if it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, it is levorotatory and it is given minus sign. See, this is the example of S lactic acid. Lactic acid is having an asymmetric carbon with a carboxylic group, a methyl group, a OH and a hydrogen atom. First of all, I'll tell you how it is S. See, out of these four groups, oxygen, carbon and hydrogen are there. Oxygen is given priority 1. Out of methyl and carboxylic group, the carboxylic group will get priority 2 as it is attached to oxygen atoms on three sides, because one double bond will be there and one OH group is there. Then methyl is having all the three hydrogen atoms. So the first priority group is OH, second is carboxylic and third is methyl. When we are going from 1, 2, 3, we move in the anti-clockwise direction. So it is S configuration. And this sign plus has been obtained by polarimeter. If it is rotating, the molecule is rotating the plane of polarized light in clockwise direction. See, the configuration is S, whereas the sign of rotation is plus, means it is rotating the plane of polarized light in the clockwise direction. The sign, this is sign of rotation and S is the configuration. S plus lactic acid. Whereas the another example, here it is sodium lactate. It is the salt of this compound. The H has been replaced by Na. Now, the configuration is remaining same, S. But when this salt was introduced in the polarimeter in the tube, in the sample tube, we saw that the rotation has been changed. It goes to the anti-clockwise direction. The plane polarized light has been rotated in anti-clockwise direction. So it has been assigned levorotatory and minus sign. In this way, now it is very clear to us that the configuration and sign of rotation are two different things. Thank you.